This is the Tapo application for the Tapo C520WS. Here we could see the newly redesigned Tapo page. Starting in the upper right-hand corner, this is the plus sign that you would select to add items to your Tapo app. And this icon right here with the red dot is our notifications pane. This lets us know that there are things that we need to address. In this case, there's some firmware that I need to correct. And then right down here, messages, you'll see for the C520WS, there was some notifications. So it says person was detected, 22 notifications. If I select on this, it will bring me into a listing of all of my notifications. So here we could see I had two persons detected. On Tuesday, I had several other person detections. Depending on the size of the SD card that you have, some of these detections might not be accessible because they're written over. So make sure that you utilize the largest SD card that you have at your disposal. But if I select on these, I know that these were taken from today. They will be there, and there we can see that is a person. Now, I bring up the notifications area there because there are other places that you can access that, but I wanted to make sure that you knew what that red dot meant. If we come to our C520WS here, we can see there's a little camera icon there with a blue tinge to it. If I select that, that will put the camera into privacy mode, meaning I can no longer view the camera and the camera is no longer recording. If I tap that again, it will take the camera out of privacy mode, meaning I will be able to visually go in and see what's going on. So tapping on the C520WS, that is the camera's live feed. Here we can see the name at the top as well as its current connectivity. Those are all options that you can add from the settings. If I tap on my screen here, we have some options down here at the bottom. First being this grid icon. If I select my grid icon, this will allow me to add other Tapo cameras to this particular feed. So if I select this plus sign right here, I can select any other Tapo camera that I have available. So right there, I can select that one. And now I can see the view from my other Tapo cameras. Now, in this particular case, the camera that I selected requires an update to actively be utilized. But here we could see I've got two cameras from one live feed. And you can see I can have up to 8 pages of that. So 4 times 8 is the amount of cameras that you can have. And then once we come back to this page, we wait for them to load. Notice I can zoom in from this view. If I want to leave the multi-view here, I would simply select the box right here. To remove one of my cameras, simply press and hold and drag up to delete. But we're going to come back to our singular view right here. In the center, we have auto. Selecting this will bring up the types of night vision mode for it to select. In this case, you've got day mode, all the time, night mode, or auto where it switches between the two. Now we have full screen mode. Selecting this will make the screen larger, allowing you to see more using your real estate on your phone. You do have option bars along the side here. We do have access to those down in this location, but just know in full screen mode, that's how things would look. Coming down, we have snapshot. Taking a picture simply is a still image of whatever the camera happens to be looking at. To the right of that is record. Selecting record will videotape anything that's going on in frame right now. And when you're done, simply select the stop button and it will save that to the playback and downloads area to the memory section. Next, we have our audio controls. Right now we could see camera's microphone is maxed out, meaning I'm going to get the best possible audio that I can from this because it's very sensitive. You can adjust as needed and notice that I have it pushed up into the red. Anything past the white there is not recommended, but for my testing, I generally put it up there. Selecting this icon right here will quickly mute the camera's microphone and then tapping it again will turn it on. Notice that it puts it back to its default state, not the maxed out setting that I had it as. To the right of that is our call. This is going to be full duplex, meaning if I tap this call button, it will make a call pretty much to the camera. Now, in real time, anybody who happens to be outside is hearing my voice coming from the camera. If they were there, they could talk back to me in real time. I can toggle my microphone on or off from here, and I could toggle my speaker on and off from here. I can also select this and end the call. If I go back to this page, you'll notice that we also have access to our pan tilt controls right from here. So if I'm talking to somebody and want to adjust the camera, let's say we want to push this down a little bit so I get a better view of that person, you could do that while still making your voice call. And to the right, we have our settings toggle, which will allow us to adjust the camera's microphone as well as the camera speakers right from this page. Coming back down, we have our talk mode, very similar as our call mode. However, instead of full duplex, we have to press and hold and we have a start talking action icon right there, which will allow us to now talk And if I remove my finger, my audio no longer is going through the camera. Just like before, we had our pan tilt options, and right here, notice the camera options are different. This is how many degrees we want things to move because we're on our pan tilt. If I came back to my talk, these then become the microphone. I like how these options dynamically change based on what you have selected instead of having to dig through another menu to try and find them. Right here, this is pan tilt. You can move the camera however you see fit, and then under that are predefined spots. So for me, I have four locations that I can quickly jump back and forth to simply by selecting an individual viewpoint. Hypothetically, if I don't like a viewpoint, I can press and hold and then select delete. Now I have freed up that spot. If I want to set a new position, I simply point the camera where I would like it to go. So in my case, I really want to keep track of this corner. I select the plus sign. You can change the name, but in my case, I'm going to leave it as viewpoint 4 and hit save. Now I can quickly toggle where the camera rotates to the front of my house or to the back of my house by my deck. That is one of the great features about this camera, is the ability to move it around to predefined points, or let's say, hey, I want to make sure that my downspout isn't over flooding my garden here. I can do that simply by moving the camera. This is why you're getting this camera, is for these options. Next, we have patrol mode. You can set your patrol mode to either patrol horizontally or vertically. So depending on where you have this placed, you might need to identify, might be tricky to see. So if you do patrol mode, you can see I have people there, but maybe I want to constantly be looking around. This is how you do it. Now, when you first do it, you do get a warning saying using patrol mode will utilize more of the motor and limit the amount of life that you get from it. So it is not recommended that you continuously use patrol mode. Honestly, if you have four set points up and have the camera kind of where you need it to be, you'll be okay. Last is this beta setting, which is this panoramic. If I reset the panoramic here, this will set up points that you can kind of slide your camera to. So we've got 360, 270, and 180. That panoramic that you saw before was a 180. If I select a 270 and then select create path, we're gonna watch in real time what this does. The camera will situate itself at its most point and then start making a panoramic shot for you. Up, down, left, right. It's going to set itself up to give you a panoramic shot. However, right now, it is calibrating the camera to make sure that it finds the center point first. And now, once it has done that, it is going to create this pathway, this panoramic shot. And you're gonna see it's gonna slowly move itself because one, this is taking an actual panoramic photo for you that you will get a copy of. But once it's completed, you can also use that panoramic shot in order to navigate to specific locations very quickly. And once it's completed, I'll show you what the final product looks like. Once completed, you can say, yes, I want to save this to the camera's memory, or no, I don't. In this case, I'm going to say yes. And right here, we have a large panoramic view of what the camera saw. So if I bring this over here and tap, it's going to swing that back over that way. Likewise, if I want to bring it back to the front, I can do that. So this is slightly different than setting up individual paths because this gives you a little more fluidity as to where you want the camera to be facing. And then right here, I can press that and we can retake the panoramic instead of having to do the refresh like I did. Last option on this side is if we select this, this will allow us to adjust the percent or the movement speed of the pan tilt when I go up, down, left, right. We're gonna select out of that and move on to our alarm. Selecting alarm does not actively turn the alarm on. This merely means that it is now engaged, and if a person or pet or a vehicle happened to come through frame, this would set that off. Next, we come to privacy mode. Selecting this, well, guess what? Just like I was talking about before, we're in privacy mode. It's not recording. It can't see anything. You can't do anything. We exit privacy mode. That's going to turn things back on, give the camera a second to initialize itself. There's no wondering, is that camera actively recording? Nope, that ball head is going to roll back on you. Right here, we have our light. If I select this, this will turn the light on for a total of 5 minutes. That can be altered in the settings area. But if you happen to turn it on and forget, don't worry, it will turn itself off after a little bit. And then we're going to come to our tag. Tagging on or off will put a tag on the live feed, letting you know what the camera is seeing, whether it's seeing a person, a pet, or a vehicle. This is one of the standout options that Tapo offers, especially in the live feed. You can even have multiple targets in a single frame, and the camera will be able to distinguish them apart. To the right of that, we have Tapo Care, which is the subscription service that Tapo offers, but is not necessary for the functionality of this camera. You'll notice that right now, during time of filming, they're having some sales. Here we have monthly for a single device. You figure it's about $3, but that's only for the first 6 months. If I select up here, kind of gives you an idea of what you're getting. 30-day unlimited cloud storage, rich notifications, which is the only thing I miss, and then smart sort. Here's your yearly price, again, for the first year, $30, and then it will go up to $35. Again, Tapo cameras are resilient in the fact that they do not need Tapo Care to function, and I'm very happy that Tapo does not cripple their cameras, putting all their good functionality behind a paywall. Coming down, we have playback and download. Selecting this will open up your camera's SD card, in my case, and here it's showing you a live feed. So right now we're in the live feed. It has reverted to our timeline. Anything in this pale blue is continuous recording. This gray means it hasn't been recorded yet. And these green lines indicate a action that has happened. In this case, green is for person. If you had just regular motion, those would be orange. Now I like the fact that it's a little hard to do around a camera, but I like the fact that Tapo actually allows you to zoom in on the timeline here to get a better idea as to where these events are. And if I select it, it will actually bring me to the event. So here you can see this is me testing out the camera. Now, if I did not want to pinch and zoom on the timeline, I can simply select an event from the event history here. And you can see this is me testing the camera and it's following me as I go about my business. Here, if I select the three dots to the right of this option, I can download this right from here, which I really appreciate because it wasn't always this simple with Tapo to do this. If I come up to my download section, here you can see these are all of the things that I have been recording with this. I can tap on a single thing, share, favorite, download, or delete right from here, or I can press and hold, and then I can get multi-select where I can select multiple items, share, favorite, download, and delete. Coming back to our downloads page, if you happen to pay for Tapo Care, there's how you can toggle on your cloud services. We're gonna come back to our front page here, and then if you happen to use the cloud, this is where you would be able to access it. Right now it's just an advertisement, but you can always turn that off if it's eating up space on your front page and you don't like it. And that was everything that we can do for the camera controls for the Tapo C520WS. Now we come up to the sprocket icon in the upper right-hand corner, and selecting this will bring us into the settings for this particular camera. And this is where you can really make modifications and changes. First and foremost, you have your device info up here. Plenty of sensitive information. I'm not going to show you that. Coming along, we have our detection. Selecting this will allow you to have what type of detections. So notice up here, auto tracking. If I select this, you have the ability to track all activity or never track. What you saw when I was showing you the downloads before, that was because I had it set to specifically track people and pets. It can do people, pets, and vehicles, and is one of the great features of this particular camera. If something happens to walk out of frame, you don't have to worry because you don't have to be manually moving the camera around. It will natively follow somebody as long as you turn that on. Here we have our detection types. We have motion, person, pet, and vehicle. Notice right here, I have a few turned on and some turned off, but if I select person, I can have on or off, and then it's sensitivity. And you can do that for each of these. We also have the ability to set up a line cross, turning that on. Your camera can have a specific line that you digitally draw on your feed, and then say if somebody crosses it going this way or this way, notify you. You also have the ability to turn on and off camera tampering, meaning if somebody messes with it. I have had this option on even in the rain and have not had any false triggers, which is great. Here we have our alarm on and off. Again, this is turning on the movement alarm, not actually turning on and off an alarm right in that moment. Here we have another way to access our pan tilt. So here we have patrol mode, and then pan and tilt angle, and then pan tilt correction. So what this will do is recalibrate the camera and return it to its most center point. Here we have another way to access our Tapo Care. Coming down, we have storage and recordings. Right now, I'm using a micro SD card. If I select this, it'll say it's good. It's showing you the maximum capability of this card, and then loop older recordings. So I could not access older recordings because I only have a 32 gig card in here. So those recordings from a couple days ago got written over because I have continuous recording set up. Now I can select to turn off my recording to the micro SD card, would not recommend it, but if I select recording schedule, here you could see continuous. I could have detection recording only or do not record. I simply select edit and then change to what I want to do. So I can say these, I only want to do detection. Hit that check mark and then it will only detect instead of continuously record on those days. And then if for whatever reason where you happen to have your camera up, you're not allowed to record audio, this is how you can turn that option on or off. Video and display, well, right here we have our night modes. So we have smart mode, which will toggle on the LED lights if it detects motion. Here I can do full color mode, meaning it will turn the spotlight on whenever you happen to be looking through the camera. And then we have our classic infrared mode. Video quality, you have from 2K down to 720, still considered HD. Here we have our frame rate. You can do 15, 20, or 25 for testing. I always put these up to 25. If you happen to have the camera upside down, you can invert the image simply by toggling it right there. Here we have our privacy zone. If I turn privacy zone on, what this will allow me to do is select an area on my screen and then block that from view. Here we have on-screen display info. I like showing the timestamp. This is your format for the timestamp. You can have text where you can format it. In this case, it's just defaulting to the name of the camera. But if this was Loading Bay 3, you can have that there. And then logo is the Tapo logo in the lower left-hand corner of my screen. And then display tag on screen. So in this case, speed or tapping live view. I like the fact that Tapo puts this right on a mock screen for you, so you get an idea as to what that will look like. Coming down, we have spotlight settings. We have a brightness toggle, which we can move left to right. Right now, it's kind of bright. You wouldn't see anything, but I do appreciate that I could turn this on and then manipulate this if it was darker. And then we have our duration on and off. You can have this on for a minimum of 5 minutes or a maximum of 30 minutes. Coming back, we have our LED status light that will let people know that the camera is actively being used and is on. Here we have our network. So if you need to reattach this to your network, this is how you can do that. We have our privacy mode, again, preventing you from seeing anything in the camera because it will roll back and not be able to record anything. Here we have notifications. I have it on, and then for activity type, you can select what you actually want the camera to send you notifications for. For in my case, I want all motion, person, pet, no vehicle, and camera tampering. I will only receive a notification for those, and it will always send them to me. However, I can select during the day only, 8 a.m. to 8 p.m., during the night only, 8 p.m. to 8 a.m., or I can designate a custom time, days and times of my choosing when I want to be notified. So I like all that customization that Tapo gives you. Advanced settings, here we have our camera account. So that would be setting up an account just for this specific camera. Power line frequency is set to auto, but it does give you options. If you don't know what that is, do stay out of those options. But if you're looking for them, that's where it is. Voice call mode, we have standard, on by default, and then compatibility mode, which will lower your call quality, but make a more stable connection for you. Display settings, here we can see hardware acceleration, best performance you're gonna get, or compatibility mode will again lower some things to give you a more stable feed, but won't get the best out of your camera. And then diagnostics, on or off, if you ever need to reach out to Tapo for assistance, they might ask you to turn on diagnostics and generate some information for them. That's how you'd be able to do that. Here we have share device. Right here, I select the share option, and then it's gonna walk me through sharing this. Notice that they will need to have their own TP-Link account in order to access your device. You have your user guide right here. So if there's anything in this video that hasn't covered something for you, you can come into here and check the user guide. Feedback, just like it sounds, you can send feedback to Tapo. And then coming down, we have firmware update. It automatically will walk you through setting up automatic updates. But if you needed to, you could manually do so from here. We can reboot our camera if we ever needed to. And then we can also remove our camera simply by selecting that. And that is everything that we can do for the Tapo C520WS.